Imagine a time. 50,000 years ago, when a group of Neanderthals huddled together in the cold of the Ice Age. Their survival was hard-fought, and their bodies were marked by the struggles of their environment. But what if I told you that these ancient humans might have had an understanding of healing, caring for each other, and possibly even practicing medicine? For a long time, we thought of Neanderthals as primitive and survival-focused, almost as if they lived in constant struggle. But recent discoveries have completely changed this view. New evidence suggests Neanderthals were capable of healing, nursing injured or sick companions, and even using plants for medicine. In this video, we're going to uncover the fascinating science behind Neanderthal medicine. One of the most compelling pieces of evidence comes from a study published in the journal Nature in 2015. A group of researchers analyzed the bones of a Neanderthal found in the Shanidar cave in Iraq, often called the Shanidar I skeleton. This individual, believed to be around 40 to 50 years old at the time of death, showed signs of severe injuries, injuries that would have been life-threatening. The Shanidar I Neanderthal had a crushed arm, an amputated hand, and signs of a severe spinal injury. But what's truly remarkable is that these injuries had healed. The Neanderthal survived for many years after these accidents, suggesting that other members of the group had helped him. Could it be that they treated his injuries with some form of medicine or care? The answer may lie in the plants that Neanderthals had access to. Researchers have found evidence suggesting that Neanderthals knew how to use plants for medicinal purposes. A study led by Dr. Christina Warriner at the University of Oklahoma in 2014 revealed that Neanderthals likely used medicinal plants to treat ailments. By analyzing dental plaque from Neanderthal remains, Warriner's team found traces of plant material, including yarrow, a plant known today for its healing properties. Yarrow has been used throughout human history to treat wounds, reduce fever, and even ease digestive problems. The presence of this plant in the dental calculus of Neanderthals suggests that they might have used it to help with their injuries or illnesses. This opens up the possibility that Neanderthals had a basic form of herbal medicine. But the healing practices of Neanderthals weren't just about plants. The evidence also points to them being skilled caregivers. In a study published in Scientific Reports in 2018, researchers examined the bones of a Neanderthal woman who had lived with a severe healed injury to her leg. The injury had been treated, possibly splinted, and the woman lived for years afterward. This woman's survival suggests that her group took care of her, possibly providing her with mobility aids, shelter, and food. This wasn't just about survival, this was about social support and empathy. Neanderthals may have had a sense of community, looking out for one another, especially in times of illness or injury. The idea that Neanderthals cared for each other in this way challenges the long-held belief that only modern humans had the capacity for empathy and social bonds. Today, researchers like Dr. Huo Zilhao from the University of Barcelona believe that Neanderthals shared a common social structure that involved not just survival, but the well-being of every group member. These new discoveries paint a picture of Neanderthals as much more than primitive hunters. They were complex social beings, capable of using the natural world to heal and protect those they loved. They cared for their injured, treated their sick, and even found ways to soothe pain with the plants around them. So the next time you think of Neanderthals, don't just picture them as cave-dwelling hunters. Think of them as caretakers, healers, and perhaps the first ancient pharmacists. If you enjoyed this deep dive into Neanderthal life, don't forget to like, leave a comment, and come back for more fascinating insights into our distant ancestors. Thanks for watching.